Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use ClearPath's auto-tuning feature. But before I start, let me first explain what tuning is and what it does for you. ClearPath is a servo motor. This means that it continuously compares what it's doing at any point in time to what it's been told to do and makes corrective adjustments. On a time scale in the microsecond range, ClearPath calculates what the proper adjustments are using a sophisticated servo algorithm. A given size motor can work with a wide variety of mechanical systems and loads because the servo algorithm is not completely hard-coded. It has a number of adjustable parameters that can be tuned to the specifics of your mechanical load and system. Given the flexibility and sophistication of the servo algorithm, optimizing all the adjustable parameters can be intimidating, and for complex real-world systems, this tuning optimization requires a fair amount of knowledge and practice. That's where the ClearPath AutoTuner comes in. It optimizes the servo algorithm for your particular machine system and loads, so you don't have to. And when the auto tuner is done, you'll have an opportunity to give a name and description, or motor ID, to the motor so that you'll remember exactly what it was tuned for. This way, if you later change the mechanics or load, you'll know to run the auto tuner again to re-optimize ClearPath's performance. So whenever you plug into a ClearPath motor, like I'm going to do right now, the ClearPath Motor Setup Program, MSP, will show you a dialog like this with the name and description that you gave the motor when you last tuned it. When the motor is new from Teknic like this one, the name will say unloaded plus the part number of the motor to indicate that it was tuned to run without a load. We do this because many people will run their motor before they bolt it up to their mechanics, and this way the tuning has already been optimized for that. But in my case now, I have this motor that was optimized to run unloaded, and it's connected to a belt stage with a carriage and load that weighs 2.9 pounds. So it needs to be optimized or tuned for this new system. So I'll click No here. The current mechanical system is not the same as the one described above, and get into the auto tuner. Now, I can run the auto tuner from here, or I could also load a file that may have been created in a previous auto tuning session. We call that a configuration file. In this case, I'm just going to run the auto-tuner. So I'll click Run Auto-Tune. And I get a warning, and a lot of people will dismiss the warning without reading, but I caution you not to do that. The ClearPath motors are very powerful for their size. People with experience with small motors are often very surprised at the power, and I really caution you, the motors can be dangerous if you don't treat them with respect. So I'm going to say I've read and understood the safety warning, and click Next. The next thing I need to do is potentially set a torque limit. The torque limit is right now set to 100%, and in this motor that means it's 384 ounce inches or 2.71 newton meters. If your mechanics can take that load, which often you've sized the motor properly, the mechanics can take well over the peak torque of the motor, then you don't have to do anything here. If you're concerned, or if you happen to know for a fact that your mechanics cannot take the full 100% torque of the motor, then here's where you can reduce it, but in a percentage way. I'll click Next to continue. And now I have a rotation distance limitation setting. Now the axis that I'm connected to, which is a linear axis, has end stops on it. So I have a limited rotation. The motor can't just spin on and on without hitting something. So I'm going to select limited rotation. Most linear axes are limited rotation. Some examples of unlimited rotation would be just a rotary axis, something that spins without limitation, or even a linear axis like a conveyor that might, you know, where the motor just keeps spinning and spinning because it's got an infinite belt loop on it. If I were to select unlimited rotation, let me click on that for a minute, then I have the choice to say whether the shaft rotates freely in both directions, which is generally the case, or if it's sort of a ratchet mechanism where it can only rotate in one direction or the other. I'm going to go back to clicking limited rotation and click Next. Now, since it is a limited rotation axis, I need to show ClearPath where the limits of that rotation are. Now, I can do that either by moving the mechanics by hand, and ClearPath will detect the movement by seeing the change in its encoder, or I can use power to move the mechanics. I'm going to start by saying I'm going to move it by hand, and then I'll show you both ways, really. I'll click Next. And now here, I'm going to turn over to my axis over here, and I'm going to move it one end, and then all the way to the other. Now, what you can see on the bar graph as I did that is that my graph turned green, which is telling me it's good. I've given it plenty of stroke to work with. The ClearPath auto-tuner does need at least 45 degrees of motor rotation in order to work properly. After that, you have enough, although four revs is a good amount, and the results are generally excellent at that point. In general, you want the axis through the full stroke of its motion. And the reason for that is because ClearPath will optimize the tuning not only in one area, but along the whole stroke of the axis. And sometimes mechanics have different dynamic responses, different amounts of compliance, different friction in different areas over the stroke. And it'll take longer to run, but it's good to let it do that because over the entire stroke, because the performance will be that much more robust. So I'll click Next here. Actually, you know what? I'll click back just to show you what would happen if I move the mechanics using power. Instead of getting the dialogue you saw a minute ago, I get this one, which tells me that my motor is disabled at the moment, and to hold the control key down to enable it, and I'll go ahead and do that. So now that I've enabled it, I'm going to jog the motor back and forth. Honestly, I don't know which direction is which with the clock, whether it's clockwise or counterclockwise, to move away from the stop that I'm on. So I'm just going to try it. There's not much that can go wrong. It won't use full torque in doing this. Now that happened to work, and I just drove it into the other end. So, and you can see I got the same 4+ revs of motion here. If we start out with this max speed set to the minimum amount, which was actually, you know, reasonably slow, but not super slow on this axis, you might want to go higher there in the case where, let's say you have a fine pitch lead screw and you want to go over a long distance. It might take forever at the speed that it's running at, so you can set it higher so it's not taking forever. Now, I can just let go of the control key and continue here, but you'll note down here, to prevent a vertical axis from dropping when finished, click the next button while still holding down the control key. So in other words, if this were a vertical load and where my stage is right now was the top, if I let go of the control button, the motor would be disabled and the load would fall. So to avoid that, you just hold your finger down on the control key while you press the next key, and the motor will stay enabled, and it'll be enabled in the next step. So now I let go of the control key, and this gives me a summary of the auto-tune setup. This is just a summary of everything I've set so far. So I click the next button, and let me just adjust this so you can see it. What happens next? This is for people who are not familiar, have never run the auto-tuner. They're sometimes surprised that the variety of noises and moves that it makes. It makes some slow, very soft moves. It makes some very abrupt, hard moves. Sometimes you'll hear squeals. Sometimes you'll hear grunts. Sometimes you'll hear buzzing, all sorts of things. And that's really the auto-tuner comprehensively testing the limits of the axis, because you want the axis to be very robust. You want it to run smoothly and quietly and with high performance under all conditions. And that, going through that whole exercise of, you know, really testing it in all areas is important. It means the auto tuning is not fast. This is not an auto tuner that happens in 10 seconds or even a minute or two. Generally, it takes, I would say, an easy axis might take 5 minutes. It's not unusual for it to take 10 to 15 minutes. And mechanics that have resonances might take as long as 30 minutes, although that's pretty unusual. So I'm going to continue. I'm going to click Next, knowing that if I want to stop here, I can press the Escape key to stop. Before I even start, though, it does give me one more opportunity. I have to hit the Run button to continue. And I also, in addition to having the escape key on my keyboard, I have this stop or escape button right here as well. So I'll click run to begin. Now you can see that not much is happening right away, and that's not unusual. It'll start out slow, it'll start out gentle, it's trying to feel its way around the axis, see what's going on. We'll just let it do its thing now. You might have noticed that the torque saturation indicator keeps flashing on. This means that the servo is using 100% of its torque, or 100% of the torque limit setting, if you've set it below 100%. For those of you who have experience with other servos, you might be wondering why we are allowing the tuning to go out of what's called the small signal range and into the nonlinear range of torque saturation. That's usually a big no-no. Well, we've designed ClearPath servo algorithm to be stable under worst-case nonlinear situations because sometimes, like when you hit an e-stop, for example, the motor will get a command for 100% torque, and we want to make sure that it'll be stable under all conditions. So the auto-tuner has finished. Also, you might have noticed that the auto-tune progress went to, I think it was maybe 55% or 60% or something like that. And that took quite a while, but then it jumped to 100% in a very short time. And that's because the last few steps of auto-tuning can either go very quickly or take quite a while, depending on the particulars of the system. So if they go quickly, the progress meter might jump from about 50% to 100% in a short time, and that's perfectly normal. So let me click Next. And now it gives me the manual control here to jog the axis to where I want it to be before I disable. And again, that's for typically in a vertical load, where you don't want it to fall. Like if this axis were all the way at the top, I might, no, that's the wrong way. I might jog it to the other end first before I disable it like that. So, and now I would disable it. So this jogging allows you to get the axis into a position that you like and do that before you disable it. So I'll click Next now. And this is the last step of auto-tuning. This is just a brief mention that there is a fine-tuning slider under the setup menu, and I'll show you that in a second. And also this motor identity setting, which I can get at from the edit menu. And I'm going to check that I want to change the motor identity settings, because like I mentioned in the beginning, the motor identity was set and it was named an unloaded motor, but now it's been tuned to work with this axis, and I want to make that clear so the next time I plug into it, I know that it has been tuned for this axis. So I'll click Finish now, and it brings up the motor identity setup. I'm going to overwrite this unloaded part of this here and just say linear. I'm going to get rid of the CPM just to give me more room. There's a limitation on the number of characters. Linear demo MCPV3411P, and that'll be its name. And I'll give it a description as well. We'll call it Macron Dynamics Linear Axis with 2.9 pound carriage and load. I'll click OK. I could click this button, which would then not remind me anymore every time I plug into this motor, but I like the reminder, so I'm going to leave this unchecked. I can always check it later if it starts to bug me. click OK, and we're all done, except I do want to show you under the setup menu here that you can go into this fine tuning menu. The auto tuner makes its best guess at an optimization between stiffness or what you'd call disturbance rejection. In other words, the servo's ability to fight off external disturbances and quietness. There's generally a trade-off between the two. The more stiffness that I ask for by setting the tuning gains or the tuning parameters higher, that gives me more disturbance rejection as a general rule, but does tend to make the motor a little bit noisier. If quietness is more important to me, then I can move this slider to the left and get more quietness at the expense of stiffness. I'm not going to change this here. Usually the middle of the road setting here, this number 19 setting, is pretty good. So I'm just going to close this, and that's it. I hope this TekTips overview of the MSP Auto Tuner has been interesting and useful. If so, please click on the like button to let other ClearPath users know. And if you want to get notified whenever we release a new video, click the Teknic logo right now to subscribe. And here are some other videos you might enjoy and find useful. As always, we welcome your comments and questions, and thanks for watching.